Chapter 2, Dangerous Flight.
That was the scene today as a freak fire erupted in the ER of St. Johnson Memorial Hospital. The firefighters were able to extinguish the flames with little damage to the rest of the building. When asked what could have been its cause, Fire Chief McDaniel replied, "It appears an unknown chemical was spilled and a short in one of the outlets ignited it." When we asked him what the chemical was, he replied with, "No comment." The rest of the patients were just happy it was taken care of before it was too late.
A black-bladed dagger smashed the television as the news went to a commercial break.
Unknown chemical in my butt. Half of my blood is spilled. Well, I suppose they have to tell the public something to cover their tracks up.
Phoenix stood up from his armchair, walking over to the television, pulling the dagger from it. Sparks shot out as the metal of the blade was removed. Setting it down on the glass table beside the smashed television, he turned, walking over to a red oak desk, where he fumbled through the papers that lay upon it.
Here it is.
Holding up one of the papers, a drawing of the artifact on it, with writing under the picture. His eyes moved from left to right, reading the page, becoming enraged the further down he read. Finally, he dropped the paper to the floor, burning on the way down. He turned quickly, furious, and threw the dagger at the wall, just missing the woman walking into the room with a cup of tea in her hands.
"Careful now. You almost hit me that time."
She spoke softly to him while handing him the cup of tea.
"Here, have some black rose petal tea. It always helps calm you down."
Taking the tea from her, he sat back down in the armchair. Sipping on the tea, his focus was back on the smashed television, still smoking.
"What troubles you?"
"They found it. They discovered how to use it against me today."
"They found what?"
"The metal of Neron."
"But I thought that was destroyed long ago."
"I thought so too, but I guess there were two of them made. He was there with them too. Organized the whole thing, I'm sure."
"Well, what did you expect? He has a job to do, you know."
"Yeah, but I'm tired of being hunted. He walked out of there alive. The body count of fire was one short. Question now is, where did he go?"
"How did they explain the fire this time?"
"An unknown chemical spilled and a short from an outlet ignited it."
She laughed lightly with his reply. He set his empty cup down on the table next to the chair as she walked over and pulled the dagger from the wall, placing it back in its case.
"It's nearly nightfall now. It'll be a good time for you to stretch your wings and get some fresh air. That'll give you time to think and plan your next move."
"No amount of planning can prepare me for what is to come. I will fly there to at least try and find out where he was taken this time."
"That's a bit dangerous, don't you think? He might see you."
"Even if he does, he can't do anything without revealing what he really is."
"True. But you should be careful nonetheless."
"I always am. They haven't found out how to track me at night yet."
"Yes. But if they still have the relic, they might be able to."
A look of worry was now on her face as she stood beside his chair, the feeling of something bad in the air. The hallway clock struck midnight as a storm began to build. He stood at the window, peering outside into the night as lightning flashed across the sky, illuminating the city skyline. The only light in the bedroom came from the lit candles and fireplace that cackled as it burned the logs. Soft jazz music filled the air as the wind blew the windows open, slamming them against the walls. She walked up behind him, placing a hand on his shoulder as she leaned against his back.
"You're not going out there, are you?"
"Yes. It's been a long time since I've flown in the rain. I could use the energy."
"What if lightning hits you?"
"I'll be careful up there."
"I still wish you'd stay and fly another night."
Maybe this time the storm will stay instead of blowing over.
Promise me you'll come back if it gets too bad out there.
I'll return.
Rain had started blowing in the open window. The candle flames danced about, throwing shadows on the walls. Stepping outside as the rain fell harder, he took his long coat off and set it on the railing of the balcony. His head hung as he closed his eyes, the cold rain running down his face. Quickly lifting his face up toward the sky, his eyes were now glowing orange as wings exploded from his back, ripping off his shirt. Four large wings now spread wide as the torn pieces of the shirt fell to the ground. They rose and fell with each breath he took, drooping down as he turned back toward her. Lightning reached across the sky once more, illuminating it behind him. She stepped up to him to kiss him, but he turned, only allowing her to kiss his cheek. She turned, walking out of the rain. Lightning flashed again on the empty balcony, his silhouette in the night air.